So many people love dairy foods, ice creams, and milks, but their stomach just can't tolerate them. Lactose-free options could be a great alternative. So on this Recipe Wednesday, Laura Buxenbaum with the Dairy Alliance is here with advice on this. And a lot of people really regret that they can't have dairy anymore, but there are options.
Yeah, so the great news for those that are lactose intolerant is that we can still enjoy the wonderful health benefits that dairy provides, as well as the delicious taste that it provides.
Okay.
So when you're thinking about foods to include, you want to reach for hard cheeses. So cheddar cheese, Monterey Jack cheese, Parmesan cheese, these are naturally low in lactose.
Okay,
so those should be easy to digest. And then your Greek yogurts have probiotics in them, and the probiotics help us break down the lactose so our body doesn't have to do it. So Greek yogurt, and then we talked earlier about kefir. That's another one that also has probiotics and is great for those that are lactose intolerant. But also, you don't want to ditch milk, because milk has 13 essential nutrients, including vitamin D and calcium for strong bones and selenium and zinc for immunity. So we really want to be drinking our milk right now. So reach for the lactose-free milk.
Good.
It's real milk. The lactose is just broken down, so our bodies don't have to do it. So you're getting the great health benefits and the great taste of real dairy.
Is lactose intolerance something that you're born with or that you can get over time?
It's typically something that you get over time.
Okay.
We see it as we get older, that our bodies just have a little bit more trouble breaking down that sugar lactose, which we find in dairy foods. So really just reaching for the lactose-free ones is the best way
to. It really can make a difference. If you haven't had milk in a while because of that, try a lactose.
Exactly. Reach for that. And there's lots of options in the dairy case for lactose-free milk.
You have a couple of recipes.
Yeah, so the other great news is that we can cook with it as well.
Okay.
So one of my favorites is like creamy soups, especially today's not really a soup day.
Yeah.
It's gonna be hot today, but fall is coming and we'll be wanting some of those hearty soups. This is a broccoli cheddar soup. So I made it with lactose-free milk, because typically we may think we would need to avoid those. So it's got lactose-free milk, broccoli, potatoes, delicious. Add cheese to it. Again, it's a cheddar cheese, so it's gonna be low in lactose, and enjoy it with a glass of lactose-free milk.
I like that. So, okay, this would be good today.
This would be great today. This is a refreshing trifle. I used angel food cake, and then I made a custard with lactose-free milk.
Okay.
So good custard, mousses, puddings, you can use lactose-free milk for those and still be able to enjoy them. Just topped it with some fresh berries. Refreshing, great summer dessert or snack.
Is there any taste difference when you're talking lactose
so
versus?
So your lactose-free milk is going to be a little bit sweeter, because that sugar is naturally broken down. So I have seen some people like it a little bit better because it has a sweeter taste to it.
Well, that's interesting.
But in these recipes, it works great. These are on our website at thedairyalliance.com, and it's a great way to enjoy milk in your diet.
It is a good thing, and it's also really healthy for you. Thanks so much for being with us. You can find these recipes on our website too, myfox8.com.